Hey, what's going on, guys? Aaron here, or Stratos, Stratosphere, and the leader of Blue Team. Hope you guys are all having a good day. I had a bunch of requests to do a gaming setup video, so here we are. So I'm just gonna show you a bunch of the products that I use on a regular basis, how I have my setup. Now, compared to a lot of YouTubers out there, this is nothing special. However, it is still pretty freaking amazing. Some people have like lights all matching and like this massive setup and everything's perfect and all the wires are hidden and stuff like that. That's something that I wanna get to, but probably won't be for a long while. However, my setup still is pretty freaking sick, so I think I'll show it to you guys. First off, we got my DX Racer chair, Canada limited edition. If you guys want a DX Racer chair, link in the description, 10% off. I'm a DX Racer affiliate. I love this chair, use it every single day. If you want any of the DX Racer chairs, there's a ton. Some of this stuff I am affiliated with, have sponsors. Some of it I am not. I will let you guys know if I am or not. But all the companies and all the products that I use are stuff that I like, otherwise I wouldn't use them, so yeah. So those are my monitors there where I do all the work and gaming stuff. However, consoles are right here. We got an Xbox One S. We got a PlayStation 4, just the regular one. This is like some random dock that I bought for like, I think 20 bucks off Amazon. It charges controllers here, however, I never use them. It just, they sit there. Add some extra USB ports here, and then both of them are able to stand vertically as well. I mostly game on the PS4 because, I don't know. I switched to the PS4 about a year after Black Ops 3 came out. I was usually playing on the Xbox. I played Black Ops 3 all the time on the Xbox One, but then I was sick and tired of being everything exclusive to Call of Duty, at least being released early, like a month earlier or whatever, all the DLC. So I finally bought a PS4 and I haven't really gone back since. I do love the Xbox though, it's still pretty cool. And I like playing Halo on it, whatever. Halo's one of my favorite games. Then we got a bunch of unorganized stuff here. Scuff controllers, games down here, random cases and stuff like that. I need to organize it, it's not that special. And then my beautiful PC, which looks like a freaking mess right now. This is a bad first setup video. So this is a custom PC that I built with my cousin just over a year ago. I'm not a huge PC computer guy. I don't know all the specs and all the things that we bought. I literally just was like, hey, Austin, what do you think we should buy? I bought all the parts and he came over and we helped build them. I'm not a total noob in the area, so I do know a bunch of stuff about it. I believe it has 16 gigs of RAM. I got a 1080i graphics card in there. I got two SSD hard drives and a 1 terabyte HD hard drive in there. It is, I think, a quad core i7. I think we got an Asus? No, not an Asus. And we also got a high-end motherboard in there. I can't remember which one it is, but we'll have text for it right here. It's a pretty good PC. It was like, it's like $2,000 Canadian, so probably about 1500 US with all those specs and whatever. It's more than enough to edit and game on and stream and do everything you need. I literally have an even more expensive MacBook over there that I used to edit on, which my editor Josh edits on now. The Mac is good, but this PC is like even cheaper than it and it's way more powerful. So if you're looking to get into gaming, even editing, I would say get a PC. I wasn't a big Mac guy before and now I'm just like, this thing, even though it's a mess with all these wires, is the way to go. All right, so this is where I sit every day, looking at these three monitors, either editing or gaming from here. We got a Razer keyboard. I literally just searched mechanical keyboard on Amazon and bought the first one that popped up and was 5 stars. It works pretty good though. Razer's a good company. Also got a Razer mouse here, and then the Black Ops 3 mouse pad. However, sometimes use this little mini guy down here because this thing pulls out. This is also a sit stand desk. A lot of YouTubers, creators, gamers have the sit stand desk that you can like push with a button, it'll raise up and down electronically. I could have bought it, but I cheaped out and bought the crank one. So you can just raise it up and down with this crank here, which is pretty sweet. For my headset, I have an Astro A40. This guy right here. Ridiculously good and comfortable headset. Customizable, all the pieces like come off so you can change them in and out. Literally wear this thing for several hours a day and they stay comfortable in my head like the whole time. So if you're looking for a good headset, I'm not affiliated with these guys at all, but I wish I was. It's a great headset, and then it comes with this little dock where you can change the volume and game audio and voice audio and whatever. This right here is a cinch controller. I used to have scuffs. They make it so that you can put buttons in the back here so you never have to take your hand off the thumbsticks. So I put X and square as my back triggers here, but scuff, they break. For my scuff controllers I had, I think I broke the left side twice and the right side 5 times, and every time those broke I had to buy a replacement kit, which was like 20-25 bucks. After that I was so sick of it. I use cinch now. Cinch has buttons on the back here, same as the scuff there, but they're buttons, and buttons don't break. They don't snap in half. So it's also a little bit cheaper and, well, more affordable, I guess I could say, in price. I do have an affiliation link in the description for that for 5% off. If you do want a cinch controller, literally anyone can sign up for it. So it's not like I'm affiliated with them, really. I don't have any contact with them or any ties. However, if you do want a cinch controller, 5% off, link in the description. I highly recommend it. It's definitely the way to go. Whenever I game on the PS4, it's what I use all the time. Okay, moving on to this mic. Now, this mic is, I don't remember what it's called. Let me Google my Amazon order. The Audio Technica 20 Series A2, no, can't speak. Audio Technica 20 Series AT2035. And then it's also got a front pop filter and it's on the Rode mic thing, whatever you call this thing. Boom. What?
Arm?
Arm? Rode Swivel Mount Studio Microphone Boom Arm. That's what it's called. This is pretty nice. Allows you to put the headset wherever you want. Hello! Did I say headset?
Yeah.
Hello! Mike. I used to have a blue Yeti Pro, and it was about 3 times the size of this, and was so heavy it would continually fall over, and it was basically the same price. Do not get a blue Yeti Pro. Get this microphone. Literally, I watch a lot of Shroud. I found out that he had this microphone, so I bought this one because I thought his audio was decent, and I do not regret it at all. Get this mic. It's good if you're willing to spend about like $200 or something like that. Now, to connect that to your PC, since that is an XLR mic, I needed a XLR to USB converter. This is a Shure 2X2U, and it's like $100. It really doesn't do much. It just converts the audio. I don't understand how it costs $100 for it to do that. I had a little bit of issues with it, but it works for the most part once I had it set up. So yeah, there's more expensive like boxes you can get. I might get one of those in the future, but for right now, it seems to do the job. So gosh, I gotta upload this video. It's finally done exporting. I edit on Adobe Premiere Pro CC or Creative Cloud. I think Adobe is definitely the best program to edit and do everything with, especially Creative Cloud, because you get Photoshop, which I use on a regular basis, Premiere Pro. I literally just finished editing Nerf Gun Game Rival Edition for my main channel. Aaron Esser, if you don't know about my main channel, like what are you doing? Go subscribe to that too, and subscribe to this channel, obviously. Let me just start uploading this video because it was supposed to be exported hours ago. So yeah, if you wanna know what I'm editing on, I use Adobe Premiere Pro. I also use Photoshop with the triple monitor setup. So right here, we got 3 monitors. These are BenQ 27-inch, BenQ Zowie 27-inch console esports gaming LED 1080p HD monitor, one millisecond response time for ultra fast console gaming. Those are the monitors that I use. I have 3 of them, all the same. They're good. When I went to COD XP like a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, and these were the monitors that they used there. So I was like, they seem pretty nice. So I bought 3 of them to have the triple monitor setup. Usually stream Fortnite daily uploads on this channel, Stratos channel, obviously. And I usually just do it on this monitor. And then I record and I stream from OBS, which is a free program. Bring it up here. There you can see that. You can see the game. You can see me right there. And it's really easy to use. It's free. You literally just search OBS, download it, and it's amazing. Pretty much everyone who records gaming videos and streams uses OBS. I don't know why you would use any other program. I always get questioned, do I use Elgato? I do use Elgato to capture my PlayStation or Xbox footage. It's literally just sitting right here. I have an Elgato HD 60S, and it basically allows you just to plug in your PlayStation through this, then back into the monitor, but it also has a USB output, and that output goes to your PC, and then you can use either Elgato software to stream or record, or then I just take that video input into the computer and then put it into OBS, and then do all my overlays and everything like that. I also use a Logitech C920 webcam. I think it's like $70 or something like that, American, and it's really simple, so easy to set up. You just plug it in and it works amazing. I'd recommend it. I was using a DSLR camera before, but it was kind of pain in the butt, way too big. So I switched to this and it's way simpler. Also, yeah, you guys have seen my lights here. I have a ring light, small one and a big one. I use these, the big one for my main videos on my main channel as well, and I have a small one here as well. So I don't even know what brand they are, just video ring light. If you're gonna spend like $100 or so or more on a video, one single video light, definitely get a ring light for sure. So to remove the background, I have an Elgato green screen here. This is amazing. Recently just got this. Literally, you just open it up and
where'd you go?
Where'd I go? And then if you look at the monitor over there, see me disappear.
Whoa.
Elgato came up with that recently and it works fan-freaking-tastic. Great way to have green screen rather than trying to put up a sheet and everything like that. This is my shelf for all my camera gear and equipment for my main channel, cameras and everything like that. And then over here is my old iMac, which Josh edits on right now. So then he's editing here and then I'm gaming over there and editing there myself. So, did I miss anything? Did anybody have any questions that they asked me about my setup on a regular basis? Also, I'm wearing Aaron Esser merch.
What?
And the hat that Catby sent to me, even though they don't sponsor me. For storage, I use WD hard drives. I have 2 6-terabyte hard drives, one for Josh and one for myself, one for that computer, one for this computer. They work okay. I just buy them because they were the best one for the price, storage-wise, and they were like 4 or 5 stars on Amazon. So that's pretty much how I do everything. That's everything I can think of right now. If you guys have any more questions for me about my setup, products that I use, or things that I would recommend, yeah, leave a comment in the description down below. Hopefully I can answer it for you guys, or maybe in another setup video in the future. I actually don't have that many other friends that stream or have a setup or anything like this. So I kind of just figured this out all on my own by watching other people and just trial and error by buying things off of Amazon, because I'm addicted to buying things off of Amazon. And I slowly built this. It's pretty sick. I like it. And hopefully it'll just keep getting better. Get everything the same color and get lights and everything like that. But that'll be in the future. So to make that all happen, you guys got to donate $1,000 on the next stream. Okay, just kidding. Don't do that. Unless you want to and have $1,000 to randomly give away to your favorite streamer, Stratos, obviously. How do people do that? I don't even know. It's crazy, man. That's the setup video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Subscribe for the daily streams, daily uploads if you haven't. Daily streams or daily uploads. That's where we're at right now. So that might change in the future. I don't know. But until then, I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.